Okay, so in the previous video we discussed how can you use the tags and attributes in HTML, and also we discussed the body tag and also its attributes, and also how to define the colors in HTML by the color name or the color code. And in this video we will discuss something about the text formatting tags. Okay, I will take only few tags how we can for the text formatting. And the first tag I want to discuss with you guys is the paragraph tag. Okay, paragraph tag, which is used to start a paragraph, and the tag which are used to define a paragraph is, the tag itself is a P, and it has only one attribute, that is align. Okay, let's see a demonstration how we can use the paragraph tag. Okay, so we'll go back to the editor. So this is my basic page. So if you want to start a paragraph here, okay, you can start the P tag, and you can type the first content. The contents for the first paragraph. Okay, so this, for example, something like this, and later you're going to start another paragraph. You can start with the another P here. Okay, so for the time being, I will copy paste these contents, and let's see how see the preview, how it actually looks. Yeah, you can get two paragraphs. Say, for example, the first paragraph is this much and the second paragraph is this much. And if you're not using the paragraph tag in between, what will happen? Let's see. So if I'm using the paragraph tag, I'm not using the paragraph tag here, so it looks something like this. So it will take it as a single paragraph. Okay, so I will change it over. I want to use a paragraph here, and an attribute you can use it over along with the paragraph tag is align. Okay, let's see. Align, and it takes the possible values are left, center, and right. So by default, if you're not using an align attribute, by default it align the contents to left. Okay, for the time being, I will change this one to align to the center, and on second paragraph I will align and to give, say, right. Okay, so let's see the preview how actually it looks. Fine, you can see the first paragraph, that is aligned to the center, and the second paragraph is, now it is aligned to the right. So normally we just used to do the sections in HTML, you can use the paragraph tag, and also there is another tag you can use, is the div tag. Later I will take the separate video on how we can use the div tag. So next text format tag I want to use is, that is in bold. Okay, if you want to make some text to be displayed in the thicker fonts, you can use the bold. And if you want to make an italic one, so you can use the tag is I tag, which is used to make the some text, or maybe the text to be to be displayed in the italics. And if you want to make some text as an underline, you can use the tag as in U. Okay, U tag, which is used to do the underlines. Let's see the demonstration how we can use the bold, italics, and the underline. Okay, I will go back to the editor. Say, for the time being, I will delete all those things. Okay. Say, I will type something. Okay. So let's see how actually it looks in the browser. Okay, so it aligned to the center itself by default. Okay, because align is given a center. I don't want to give a center. Okay, so display something like this. For example, I want to make this Department of Computer Science to be placed in the next line. You can use a tag called as BR. Okay, so brack tag. Fine. So now it comes to the next line. For example, I want to make it as in bolder, this one, STM. Okay, so you can use the tag as in B tag. And after this in STM, you have to close the B tag. To close the B tag. Let's see the preview how actually it looks. You see now the SDM, this is displayed in a thicker. For example, you want to make something in italics. So the next, I want to use a italics I. Okay, close I. Okay, and see the preview. Now you see the college will be displayed in italics. And another one is an underline. For example, I want to make computer science an underline. You can use a U tag, and you can close it by the close U. Yeah, now this the computer science has got underlined. Okay, this is how you can use it over. Okay, one thing is, if you want to make something to be displayed in the center of the web page, Either you can use a paragraph and make the attribute align is equal to center. And one more tag you can use it over is center tag. Okay, for example, like everything to be displayed, this is a separate tag you can use is center. And for example, like I want to close here the center. Now you can see the preview. Now see the STM College Hujre, now it is placed the center. Okay, so either you may use here this paragraph align is equal to center, or you can use the tag itself center. Okay, next we will see about one more tag that we call the heading tags. Okay, so there are different the versions of heading tags you can use it over, that is H1 to H6. H1 means that is an heading tag which have a the highest font size, and H6 which have a the lowest font size. Okay, let's see a demonstration how we can use this in header tags. Okay, say and after this I want to give the heading, say for example like H1 heading and close in the H1. Okay, for the time being I will copy paste the contents. Okay, I will see the preview, actually it looks, see the heading H1 I used here is to have an highest font, then comes the next highest font, something like this. You can use the header tags from H1 to the H6. Okay, so the last tag in a text formatting I want to discuss is an horizontal ruler or maybe the HR tag. Okay, so if you want to make two sections and that will be divided by a horizontal line, you can use an HR tag. Let's see how we can use an HR tag. Okay, for example, like in between this, I want to make a HR. Okay, so here you can use it over the HR tag, and let's see here, horizontal ruler. Okay, so a line may place in between so that you can separate the two contents. And it also has the attributes. Some of the attributes of this can give the color. Say for example green you want to give, and say if you want to define the size, that is in height. Okay, so that is in pixels, you can give say for example 5 pixels, and even you can define the width also. Okay, width even you can define it over in pixels or in percentage wise. Say for example I want to give in percentage wise, say 80%, that in the sense with the respect to the web page it will display 80% of the web page. Okay, I will save this. Okay, let's see this. Okay, so now the 80% of, and though the height will be given as 5 pixels and the color is the green. Thank you.